Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Rebecca and I make fashion videos. Feel free to subscribe if you like watching them. Today's video we are going to be doing an Aritzia unboxing slash haul slash try on, where I basically show you 8 of my favorite pieces from this season, try them all on, give you my thoughts and feelings, tell you what they're all about, and that's all. Let's get into it. I just want to start off by saying that all of these pieces were extremely kindly gifted from Aritzia, so thank you so much, Aritzia. Maybe it's the coolest thing that's ever happened to me, I don't know. It's up there, so thank you. So this first sweater here I am wearing is the Little Moon Gimlet sweater. This one I got in a size small in the color pink, obviously, but it also comes in a cream color. This sweater has blown my mind. It is 100% merino wool, Italian merino wool. I don't know if the sheep in Italy are better than the sheep worldwide, but anything Italian just seems beautiful to me. So I'm obsessed with this sweater. Like I said, I got in a size small. I think it fits well. I don't think I would consider a medium because I do like the way it fits through the arms and just has like enough billow in its little princess shoulder moment. It is a 3/4 sleeve, which is definitely different than what I would typically be drawn to. I don't usually wear sweaters, if I'm quite honest, but I am trying to branch out from the hoodies that I wear on a daily basis. So this is kind of this is making a good case for sweaters. It is a beautiful length. It's not super cropped, but maybe a little bit more cropped. And because of the banding around the waist, I feel like it'll be super versatile in the way of being able to like flip it up if you wanted it to hit a little bit shorter on your waist, or wear it down maybe if you want to style it that way. But I do think it is super nice and I am super excited to wear this all winter long. The next item up is the Wilfred Free Melina pant. Now, these are a faux leather pant. They cost $148 and I got them in a size 6. I haven't owned faux leather pants in a million years, so I'm super excited about these. I'm also super curious to see how these pants wear, because back in the day when I was 19 and working at Aritzia, that's when they had originally launched their first faux leather leggings, and they stretched out a ton. So people were advised to go like 2 sizes down, get them so you could barely put them on, because then they would stretch out and they would be the perfect fit. So I'm curious to see how these go. I definitely could have sized down to a size 4 in these. In most brands, I do wear a size 4, but I find in Aritzia, I usually go for a 6 just to be a little bit more comfortable. So I feel like I could have gone for a size 4 in these, especially if they're gonna stretch out, but we shall see. Only time will tell. They are a straight fit and they do hit me at about the ankle. And for reference, I am 5'8", so I'm a little bit on the taller side. And I could definitely see them stacking up on foot if you were a little bit shorter. They feel like super nice quality. And one of my favorite things about these actually is that they're made to look like an actual pant. So they do have a button and fly. They have fully functioning pockets. They have belt loops. And as someone who doesn't typically wear leggings to begin with, I think I'd be less inclined to wear these if they were just like a faux leather legging. So the fact that they look more just like leather pants, I think that's super cool. Looking at the website now, the description of these pants do say that they're made with Japanese fabric that's crafted for superior shape retention and an authentic leather look. So to me, that sounds like they've adjusted the fabric so it should hold its shape a little bit better than the old styles did, which is very exciting. All right, you're not seeing double. It's just another hot pink princess shoulder knit sweater here. This is the Wilfred Nessa sweater in the bright fuchsia pink mix. And this one is $148 as well. But it also comes in a constant caramel, which is a nice like caramelly shade, beigey caramel shade. Really beautiful. So obviously you can tell the coloring is different. This one has like a nice stripe to it. And it's almost more of a crochet effect rather than the like tight knit that I'm wearing. This one you can kind of see through a little bit. The holes in it are a little bit larger. And it's also more of a cropped fit, so it's gonna hit you kind of right at like the top of your high-rise pants if that's what you chose to wear, which is super great because high-rise pants are pretty much all I wear. God, Aritzia is just on top of all the really luxurious fabrics. This one's made from alpaca merino wool blend from Italy, again, all the Italian sheep. And it's super beautiful, it's super nice. It reminds me of the cardigan that they had in the summertime. I don't remember what that one was called, or maybe it was end of summer. I had tried it on and I did like it, but I just wasn't sure how much I would wear it. But really, truly, now apparently all I do want to wear is pink knits. So I'm glad we've got many of them. The thing I think I like about like these really feminine knits is being able to pair them in a less feminine way. Like I feel like wearing like a big chunky pink knit like this with like a baseball cap and like some sneakers is just like super cute and realistically the way that I'm gonna end up wearing them. The next item I have is the Little Moon Malva check pant. These are a high-waisted, almost like crop. Siri thinks
that doesn't sound good.
Look what she thinks I asked her. Mind your own business, Siri. I'm busy. So the next item I have is the Little Moon Malva check pant. These are a high-waisted, kind of cropped, flare-legged pant. If you're a little bit shorter than I am, like I said, I'm 5'8", so I'm quite tall. They're quite cropped on me. They could be like an ankle-skimming pant on a small girl, which would be really cute as well. The color of them is like this yellow and brown checked color, and it's like a houndstooth. Really, they just scream autumn. Like, I'm two steps away from carrying around a pumpkin spice latte, and I was gonna say a bunch of leaves. People don't do that. The next item, it's like a space jacket. This is the Super Puff Shorty in obviously a metallic silver. Is that what that is called? Silver reflective. I got this guy in a size small and it retails for $225. This is a down jacket, and I believe on the warmness scale it is warmer, so it's good for minus 20 Celsius or minus 4 Fahrenheit. I'm super excited about this jacket because if you saw my outerwear video, you all know how much I love outerwear. If you haven't seen it, I'll link it up there. I love outerwear and I love funky outerwear because really, when it comes to winter in Canada and getting dressed and wearing clothing in general, you spend the majority of your time out in front of people in outerwear. So you gotta make a good outerwear, like this. This is such a good fit. The hood zips off, which is also nice because I feel like until it gets like icy cold, I'll probably wear it without the hood just for, you know, comfort. You don't always want all that bulk up there. And the length of this one is really good as well. And I do have a lot of long winter jackets and I do wear those when it gets down to like minus 30, minus 40. But this will be fun leading up to that. What else can I tell you about this jacket? It is Responsible Down Standard Certified. So responsibly sourced goose down fill. I don't know what the certification means, so I can't speak on that more, but they do claim to be responsibly sourcing their goose down fill. It is a 700 plus fill power, super warm and super light. I believe in comparison, North Face jackets are usually like a 600 down fill, so this should have a little bit more down per square whatever of jacket. The fabric is supposed to be weatherproof, so it's water repellent and wind resistant. One thing to note about that is it does say water repellent, so it's not waterproof, but the water is most likely going to bead off and it's not going to soak you. And then there's a down resistant construction, which basically just means the little feathers aren't going to be poking out of your jacket all over the place, which is also nice. The bottom does have two little cinchy things, so if you wanted to cinch in the waist and didn't want such a boxy fit, you could totally do that, which I actually think would be super cute to create more of like a full bubble effect to your body. And that's pretty much it. Oh, and those jackets are machine washable and super puffs, which is like key because, like, I don't know, winter jackets, you wear them so much and I feel like you wear them so aggressively that it's important to be able to wash them. The next item, something similar to what we've seen before, but this is the Little Moon Calathea check skirt. So it's the exact same fabric as the trousers I showed you a minute ago, except for it's a mid-length pleated skirt. I am really having a big skirt moment, and I just think that this one is super, super beautiful. Again, I can see myself dressing this up a little bit more when I'm like feeling a little zesty, want to get out of the hoodies and jeans. Definitely going to throw this on. I'm gonna admit, when it gets a little bit cooler, I like my legs covered. Don't necessarily always want to wear tights. I'm like not opposed to wearing jeans under skirts, and I know that that is probably a hot topic that people will have many opinions about, but I think it can look really cool. Not saying that I'm going to, because this skirt is fitted kind of across the tummy area and I feel like you'd just be able to see like all the pockets and buttons and stuff in jeans. I just think it's cool, but I'm gonna try and think of some creative layering ideas for this skirt that's like still look cute, you know, so I can continue to wear it for a long time because it's already getting cold here in Toronto, sadly. Oh, I didn't even tell you any of the details on the skirt, sorry. It's $138 and I got it in a size 6, which is the exact same as all the other pants I've gotten. I think if I really wanted to, I could cut down to a 4, but I do like having the flexibility of being able to tuck something in to skirts and pants and stuff, and I'd rather not feel like a stuffed sausage. I'd rather be able to hit the buffet confidently and not have to leave my pants unbuttoned or my skirt undone. The next item. is this auxiliary wool cuff beanie. This is a massive beanie. Sorry, I've already got dog hair on it. It's literally been in my house for maybe an hour. This is, to my surprise, 100% merino beanie. And it is a massive, massive beanie. Let me show you. So the fabric on top, you guys are probably all laughing at me right now. It's not quite as stiff as maybe like the acne beanies in comparison. Comparing like large beanie to large beanie, this one is a little bit more flimsy. It kind of does what it wants. Whereas the acne beanies kind of like hold their shape a little bit better. The wool is a little bit more stiff. Whereas I think because this is a merino wool, I was gonna say sweater, merino wool hat, it has a little bit less structure to it. But I think it's great. Merino wool is a great fabric. I've been looking for larger beanies, which is like a complete pendulum swing to me in the last few years, where I was like, oh, like the teeny tiny beanies that I just wear above my ears and they don't do anything but protect the top of my head. No, I want the big beanies. Give me all the big beanies. I want extra warmth. I want to like nestle up inside the beanie, maybe build a home in it later. I don't know. It also comes in a teal color. God, I'm forgetting all the facts. It's also $58. The teal color is actually probably the exact same color as my hair, so that's why I opted for the black one. And for my last trick, by trick I mean item, this is the TNA Super Puff Tote. Because just when things can get puffier or more pink, I just throw on a pink puffy tote. I don't know what to tell you guys. I'm very excited about this. I love hot pink accessories. I've said it a million times before and I'll say it a million times again. I don't know what it is. They just speak to my soul. This is just quite literally a big tote. It's got a zipper on top, black lining. It does have some nice pocket detailing on the inside with like a zipper pocket, so you can keep like things that you want to have better access to rather than just throwing them into the depths of the bag. This would actually be a nice like travel bag too, if you were going away for like maybe one night, or if you wanted to bring it as like your carry-on double-edged pillow. I also am a huge fan of the pillow bag trends. Obviously the Margiela bag that came out a couple years ago, the Bottega Veneta bag that came out I think fall winter this year, and the Marc Jacobs bag that just came out. I'm a huge fan of all of them, and this is one I can definitely get behind, and I'm excited to wear with all my stuff. Honestly, like, this color palette is delicious. It's blowing my mind. Oh my god, that bag is $78. I'm sorry, I will get better at this one day. The bag is $78. It is a polyester lining. It's not a down bag. Which, why really would you need it to be? Anyways, guys, that is all I have to show you. Those were all 8 items that Aritzia kindly sent over to me. Thank you so much again, Aritzia. I will love you forever. And I probably still have my Brian Bucks somewhere in my house. If you worked at Aritzia and you know what Brian Bucks are, please leave a comment down below, because that's something special. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know what your favorite piece is from this haul. I don't know what my favorite piece would be. I'm really quite partial to all of them. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video.